Hello everyone, I'm Argama Witch, and today I'm going to show you how to use VSeeFace. VSeeFace can be obtained at vseeface.icu. You can scroll down from the main page and just click the latest version. This version is slightly more updated than the one I'm going to be using, but it's fine. It's going to be a zip file, you're going to unzip it, and then you're going to launch it. So you'll end up with You'll end up with a file like this, and then you're going to see this vseeface.exe, and you're going to double click that, and it's going to end up launching the program. Give it a second to load. Now yours aren't going to have avatars in here, I use this one, so... Yeah. So what you're going to do is click on Add Avatar, there might already be one in there. If there is and you don't want it there, you can simply just, you know, select it and then hit remove avatar. But click add avatar, find your VRM, and you can add it. You're gonna hit OK. We're gonna end up using this one, I guess. Yeah, that's fine. Now you're gonna come over here and make sure you select your web camera. There's a drop down menu with your web cameras. If you don't see your web camera here, you might need to install your web camera. 30 frames, high quality, and then a microphone. Let's see, for here I'm going to use this. Okay. And then we're gonna just hit start. Now it's gonna take a moment to kind of configure, I guess you would say, your model. It's going to take a moment to track where your facial points are and, you know, talk and move and whatever. But at this point, you're pretty much, you know, working. But we're going to talk about a couple of the settings real quick. Alright, so first we have the general settings. And one of the things that you should keep in mind is the auto blink, if you want to auto blink or not, which some people tend to turn on if they use glasses. Linking the blinks so then you don't have like one eye blink and the other one not. Smooth blink is basically, it's not just gonna like, your eyes aren't just gonna open and close, there'll be a transition type of deal. If you want lip sync on, you can turn that off so it just kind of mimics the shape of your mouth and how it's moving. I usually try to keep on, a hybrid, lip sync hybrid tracking thing, whatever. Yeah. Shoot, I made that way out of, I can't reach it now. Oh, now I'm using a different one. okay. So anyways, over here, you're gonna see a whole bunch of different options, and this is basically how your body is going to react to tracking. So like I can adjust like where the eyebrows are, like how great the movement of the eyebrows are, and then like the sensitivity of the tracking, and like the strength. It's going to do like high and low or whatever, you know. And then like the lip sync audio over drive gate. Look, these are a lot of ones you just kind of want to mess around with. And it's just your preference. And this is where you want your arms to be. Alright. Right about here seems about a natural place. Size reduction, so you can have like a really tiny little like barely moving mouth, or you can have rah, rah, rah. I like the big mouth. I have a big mouth. I want to show my big mouth. And then like you have body stiffness, which, you know, so depending on like how much you actually move. Issues that I do see with VSeeFace is the clipping through the face, with hair. Like, you see how my hair goes through my face? That's something I've noticed for this particular program. But it is what it is. It's a free program, man. Like, how can you even complain? Then there's also this expression detection, which is something where it tries to mimic what it thinks your expressions are based on how your face is. And it'll trigger them accordingly. And then the experimental one, which you kind of set in and you help calibrate what it's going to look like. I don't use this at all. I tend to not do expression detection. Mostly because I have the happy resting bitch face, and if I did, then I would fucking just look angry, like, all the time. Because it's tracking kind of where your eyebrows are. Not to mention that it jumping between all of these is kind of weird when you're a little animated. So, yeah. You can also show your tracking points, which, kind of shows, like, Yeah, anyways. It kind of gives you an idea of, like, what you're working with as far as what it's tracking. So, like, if for some reason your mouth is looking weird or tracking weird, you can put that on and kind of see what it's trying to track. Yeah. The other one I would say is check out the expression settings. And this is where you can trigger your hotkeys. I tend to use the numpad because it's easier for me to reach. And I also have the extra ones in there, which I'll have to do. Now, you'll notice how, like, this here says base. Like, so if I hit it, it's gonna, like, apply over the base model, right? And since it's on hold right here, it means that as long as I hold this key, it's going to trigger. Whereas over here, you see the hat. And yeah, my hat, it says blue, but it's actually black. Since it's an additive, it adds it on top of the base, so it's not going to do it instead of. And since we're toggling it, it means every time I hit it, it'll come on and off. There's also a transition time if I want to, like, kind of have it fade in and out a little bit. So if you couldn't tell, this is still my blue hat. I've just painted it black. And, like, for this one, I could... Let me get rid of this. And we can still do additive to this. This is going to look a little weird. And the transition, for this one, the transition has to be fast because you can see it, like, the movement in the eye. Yeah. So I do it really fast. Yep. But, you know, it's just an extra on top of the base. I don't think I have Palma on this one. No, I do. There he is. Ba-bum! Ba-bum! Alright. besides that, if you find yourself, like, facing in a weird direction, you can just reset position. And it'll kind of, like, bring it back. Drift back to normal is if you don't have that on and your model kind of gets stuck off into the side somewhere, it's not going to slowly move itself back. It'll kind of stay there. I kind of like the drift back to normal, just in case. And then there's drift speed, so, like, you know, you're not moving much here, but if I increase it, it's slowly moving me back forward. And this is pretty good if you have something like you're playing games or whatever. And you need to suddenly, like, just look at another screen or something for a while instead of it just, like, your character's, like, facing in a weird direction. It'll slowly move back to normal. It's totally up to you. So now there's this button down here. This is going to make everything transparent. You can see the grid here. And then if you hit the space bar, it's going to remove that little thing. This blue bar means that my tracking is getting really close to the bottom of my face. If it's on the top, it means, like, And let's see, over here, see, yeah, you can see kind of like it's losing tracking in these corners. So it might have a little trouble tracking in those areas. When you go to use this in something like Streamlabs, what you're going to do is you're going to do like plus, and then you're going to do a game capture instead of a window capture. So you know, add the source that's already there. All right, and then what you're going to do is you're going to allow transparency. If you do not have allow transparency, then it's going to still show this grid in the back. Yeah, you see? There we go. I know this is a little inception-y, but, you know, we do what we do because we do the do-do. Anyways, I'm sorry. I'm tired, and it's been a long week for me. but anyways, this is briefly how you use VSeeFace. Thank you guys for watching my videos. If this video has helped you out, please leave a like on it. And if you have any questions, you can ask them down below in the comments. And if you like my content and you want to see more from me, or you like the boing boing energies, then please subscribe, and I will see you in my next scuffed video. Okay, bye. So, if you have any questions, you can leave them down below. I don't know what else to say. But yeah, if you have any questions, you just leave them down below and I will do my best to try to answer them and whatever. Yep. So I forgot how to end my video. Shit.